enjoyed it. Retired, but still very well known as the leading search in separating Siamese twins. Six months ago, I designed an never seen operation, not separating anymore, but creating. I transformed my three walk widers into a beautiful three hour construction. Good news. Your tissues match. So, I'll explain this. Operation only once. We start with cutting the ligamentum patellae, the ligaments of the kneecaps. So we extend them as long as possible. Pulling from B and C, the central incisors, lateral incisors, and canines. From the upper and lower jaws. The lips from B and C, and the anus of A and B, are cut circular along the border between skin and mucosa. The mucus retaining zone. Two pedicellular grafts are prepared and lifted from the underlying tissue. V-shaped incisions below the chins of B and C up to their cheeks. Connecting the circular mucosa and skin parts of anus and mouth. From A to B. B to C, connecting the pedicellated grafts to the chin cheek incisions from A to B, and B to C, creating a Siamese triplet connected via the gastric system, ingestion by A. Passing through B, the excretion of C. The human centipede.
I'll be honest, that wasn't real shit. But I probably would have been happier if it was. You finished it. What did it taste like?
Strawberries.
Strawberries. I don't know what fucking strawberries you've been eating. That tasted more like fucking dingleberries. You know what tonight is, ladies and gentlemen? It's the blue moon. Strange things happen on a blue moon. The first bar in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania that ever gave me a chance was named the Blue Moon. It's as if the stars and the planets and the moon have aligned. I want you to know, everyone in this room, I'm so fucking happy to be here. I'm on a national tour right now, basically selling my blood, sweat, tears, and artistic integrity to pay the fucking bills. To make money I never cared about, but now I feel like I have to maintain. But when I was 20 years old, and I got my own apartment, and I got my own computer, a lot of the fags I ran around with loved it for porn and like finding guys on gay.com, and I think the most important thing I ever found on the internet as a youngster was an underground anarchistic button pushing drag troupe called the Trannyshack. I am so fucking proud to be here right now. If it wasn't for queens like Heclina, if it wasn't for queens like Lady Bear, if it wasn't for queens like Becky Motor Lodge and Peaches Christ and Cousin Wonderland, if it wasn't for these legendary performers, I don't even think I'd be standing on the stage, let alone being your current Miss RuPaul's Drag Race superstar. Well, you guys don't have to stay. Oh, can you guys please give a round of applause for my human centipede? Of course, at the front, I just want to let you know, Andrew and Adrian, you guys have been such a huge supporter of me before RuPaul's Drag Race ever started, and you let me stay in your mansion and trash it, and thank you so much. And Lady Bear, I don't know how to express how much of affection I have for you, because you're the only, you're still one of the only San Francisco queens that still gets drunk, and I really appreciate that. And Boom Boom, words can't express how much you've inspired my personal art to always take it farther, to always make it messy, always leave them with a message, and always make them fucking gagging. And I'm not talking about beauty, I'm talking about actually puking, so. Thank you guys so much. Oh, they're trapped together, they can't.
I love you, sir.
Thank you guys, thank you. And it's really weird to be kind of like a downtown, drunk, punk rock, Pittsburgh clown that, you know, just kind of use drag as a medium to say fuck you to the world and fuck you to our fears and fuck you to all the social qualms that everyone wanted us to adapt to. And that's why I created the House of Haunt, which is very similar to the Tranny Shack, except we're pretty. The House of Haunt, which is my drag house in Pittsburgh, is a... Thank you guys so much. The House of Haunt is a drag collective that basically took every queen that nobody wanted I find beauty in flaw, and I am inebriated by people that put themselves in front of an audience in a costume and in makeup to express themselves. And you know, any drag troupe in Pittsburgh, you know, that wouldn't take a queen or they kicked a queen out, I would fucking take them, because you know what? The true beauty remains in flaw, and that's why I love the Tranny Shack, because true beauty and true artistic tension relies on people that have a message. We're not here to show off our silicone titties and shake it to a Lady Gaga number. We're here to really make you think, really make you sick, and really push buttons. So I want you guys to applaud everyone that's been involved with Tranny Shack tonight. I usually do really funny, gory numbers, and to anyone who was not expecting my first number and wasn't really entertained, I would like to apologize. But we dream of something that is bigger than ourselves, and we dream to obtain something that is almost impossible to obtain. And sometimes when you get what you want, you realize that it's almost there designed to hurt you. So I apologize to anyone who found my first number to be a little too emotional, but I've been going through it lately, and the only place I thought I could take that number was right here at Tranny Shack. I'm not lying when I say that I miss that I was poor, and I miss just being a punk rock clown in Pittsburgh, and I miss spending times with my friends and my family and my cat and my hearse and my rotten house. I guess that the only statement I can say with that first number, and I would like to apologize for anyone who wasn't entertained, is that be careful what you wish for, and I really mean that. Go on, not complaining. But besides that, can I get a Hail Satan in here?
Hail Satan!
Can I get a Hail Satan in here?
Hail Satan!
I love saying Hail Satan in LA because all the ballet girls say, oh my God, like 20 times a day, and it drives me fucking crazy. Is everyone getting drunk tonight? Can anyone even make it to the bar? Heck, Lena made a little off-color joke about me doing cocaine in my dressing room. And since the press is here, I'm going to say that that is completely untrue. I would also like to say that RuPaul always told me to lie to the press. So, the good thing about being pale is they can't tell if it's highlighting powder or not, you know? No, it's true. I love getting drunk. It's what I do when the sun goes down. And I drink so much Pabst Blue Ribbon that when Pabst Blue... Yeah. That when Pabst Blue Ribbon does its taxes, it puts me down as a dependent. It really does. It really does. I'm so happy to be back in LA and not be doing some big boom boom club or where all the faggots with the perfect teeth and the plucked eyebrows and the pop pink collar shirts and their daddy's credit cards. There are true beautiful people in this audience tonight. I'm so happy to hang out with you guys. I have a couple of friends here tonight that I just want to give a quick shout out to. A great friend of mine who I never thought I would be friends with. His name is Matthew Anderson. And if you're not familiar with him, he's RuPaul's makeup artist, hairstylist, and he does her robotics. He's the one that makes her move. So I don't think there'd be a Sharon Needles without him. And also, one of my idols is also here tonight. Her name is the glamorous Monique. And for those of you who aren't aware, she's one of the most fantastic examples of American exaggerated transsexual beauty. And she's a true fan of mine. I can't leave the stage without mentioning them. But at the end of the day, I mean,
happy Halloween!
Art is dead, Tranny Shack lives. Yeah. You know? I'm not quite sure how long Tranny Shack has been going on, but I know it's been going on for several years and has inspired my personal art. And without things like Tranny Shack and the Cockettes from San Francisco or the Church of Saint from San Francisco, I don't think there would be a Sharon Needles. So art is dead, Tranny Shack lives. I can't keep white clean. I don't belong in heaven. Red is my color. I'll see you all in hell.